Hello? I want to take you on a journey through time and space. And we're starting in Northampton in 1974. I was about 14 years old, browsing through the records at my local village store. There was Beethoven Goes Pop, the Swingle Sisters, but amongst them, there was Camembert Electrique in its scruffy black and white cover, and it was only 50p. So I had to buy it. It was actually one of the first releases of Virgin Records. And it's strange to think that Richard Branson was once a popular hero. And the actual price was 59p, so I only got 9p off from my cut price store. But I took it home, put it on the record player, and was forever transformed.
Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert?
Tu veux un camembert?
Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert? Tu veux un camembert?
Yeah. gentlemen. I fell down.
Thank you very much. It just so happened that the first band of note that I saw in Northampton, my hometown, was Gong, who came in 1976. Actually, they came without David Allen because he was having problems walking onto a stage. It wasn't until much later that I got to see David Allen play with Gong, when he said the only words he ever said to me, which were, "This is the worst PA in the history of rock and roll." And he said it as if it was my responsibility. But actually, this is a love story. In 1979, I found myself squatting in an attic room in Balham, South London. I had one record with me, which was, of course, Camembert Electrique.
Tu veux Camembert?
And there, a seduction took place. Now, so what? Surely there have been so many similar seductions. Well, not really, because I can remember this one. And the strange thing is, the very woman involved is here tonight. Henny, show yourself. There she is. Now, Henny, do you remember Camembert Electrique playing in the background? What do you remember about that event? You remember being slightly squashed? Now I've forgotten what I was going to say. Anyway, I may have not have been Dynamite or your animal, but I like to think that the what the Concords call business time occurred during Fohat digs holes in space, and here we go.
Thank you. take pills to kill my pain, kill my pleasure, I blow my brain. I get so high, I got nothing again. What's happening, man? I gotta drink booze to help me swing, and the doctor to help me sing. Gotta smoke grass to help me see. Who are you, babe? Mirror on the wall, who's the biggest fool of all? Hallucinating critical, what's the deal?
Thank you everyone for coming. I've waited about 4 years to realise this project. It took me moving to Bristol to make it happen, where I've met some wonderful people. I'd like to introduce them to you. First of all, in the sound booth, Keith Chemistry.
Keith!
Keith is a stalwart of the Cube Orchestra, as is Marcus Valentine on keyboard. From the Fantasy Orchestra, I picked up a few waifs and strays. They are Osian Haines on tenor sax. Can I just correct that? I keep calling Osian Haines, it's Osian Haines. Well, he got a double introduction. Mel Wickham on baritone sax and flute. And Jake Cheeseman on drums. And I had to go to Asteroid Deluxe to find the people perfectly suited for this task. They are Andy Taylor. And, Crosby needs no introduction, Gaz Williams. Sophie's been staying with us for a week.
Taking it for granted.
And Sophie is from Fantasy Orchestra Paris. And spending a week in Bristol, well, sorry, a month in Bristol. And during that time, I've roped her into how many evenings rehearsing and playing in different bands. Sophie Urbania.
Was she leaving Russia from the Prada by a brand new husband? All I want to know is just what happened to your latest food.
Like a typical witch to me, she seems like a tropical fish to me, but you can't get me, it's like that bag is in me. Stranger and stranger, why do you do it? Stranger and stranger, why do you do it? Stranger and stranger, why do you do it? Stranger and stranger, why do you do it?
Yeah.
Is an experiment in Bliss through Gliss Guitar Orchestra. This was an idea conceived by David Allen and Steve Hillich way back in the 70s. Originally for 8 guitars, we're using whatever resources we have to really create a series of drones. They all follow a particular pattern through the octave. No doubt we should be in contact with David Allen's octave doctors. I don't know if you're familiar with them. We'll be starting about 20 minutes. Sit back, relax, and buy some drinks in the bar. See you about 10:15.